the Caps and the Sharks tonight. Let's welcome in Jamie Baker to talk about this matchup and talk about the Sharks side of it. Let's start by asking about San Jose and their leaders. React to dealing with the short-term struggles we're seeing from them. They've lost three straight, and as I mentioned, they've given up six goals in each of those losses. What's the mood like in the room?
They're confident. I mean, this is a group that doesn't panic. You know, coming into this three-game stretch where they've lost on the road, obviously they've been giving up too many goals, too many power play goals. But they've liked stretches of the games. Arizona, to their credit, played a great game against San Jose. San Jose had one of their best games of the year the night before against Pittsburgh. Sharks had won seven in a row. So then you come into Tampa, you make a few mistakes, you put them on the power play, they make you pay, and so did Florida last night. So Sharks are looking to just kind of simplify their game, but you look at Pavelski, Burns, Thornton, these guys have been around for so long, they don't get caught up in all the highs and lows of the regular season. So the mood is still good, but they definitely want to go into this All-Star break with a win. They don't want to go in with a four-game losing streak.
And we all know that the All-Star break will be in San Jose. How important is Erik Karlsson to the Sharks, and should he play in the All-Star game weekend?
Well, I'll work in reverse. Should he play? I'll steal the words of Pete DeBoer, who's obviously the head coach. He goes, I just want him healthy. So it'll be interesting to see. This is the third game that Erik Karlsson is missing with an injury. Nobody has said what the injury is, but it'll be interesting to see whether he actually plays later this week. I'm sure we'll get an announcement in the next day or two. How important is he to this team? We've seen once he's settled in after a month or so how important he is. Just the point streak that he had. But it's not just that. It's the dual combo of he and Burns. When they're playing, it puts other teams on their heels. Those guys can make one pass that can beat two or three guys. So you got to be real tentative sometimes on the forecheck. You want to get in on them, but you don't want them to make a play that could lead to an odd man rush or a transition opportunity for the Sharks. Those guys are both so good at it. So that dual combo can be deadly. The Sharks were winning, so obviously they missed Karlsson quite a bit.
We know Doug Wilson is one of the best in the business. We know the trade deadline is looming just over a month away. What type of player would the Sharks covet if the price was right to make a run?
If the price is right, it's always so important. Assuming Karlsson is healthy, assuming Vlasic is back and healthy, you've got one of the best, if not the best, defensive core in the NHL. They're going to look for a forward, preferably top six, again, if the price is right. And even there, I think if they could get a centerman, that allows them to potentially use Hurdle on wing or center. Pavelski can always slide in, but if you can get a top six guy that can score, that can play good in all three zones of the ice, it really will help them slot the forwards. I mean, Joe Thornton's already accepted the third line center role, so it could create some mismatches down the stretch and in the playoffs.
Jamie Baker, great insights. Enjoy the game tonight.
Thanks, Tony.